Everyone, this is Manny from GlazTech. Today I would like to talk about cutting wall extrusion stock lengths and the weight. Normally when we doing takeoffs for estimating, we got quantities, we got stock lengths. But we don't know how much weight for each stock because the system, our Carnier catalog, or whoever, even a Lumico or US Luminum, no one tell you how much weight per stock for the aluminum or rubber. So how we can get the weight of cutting walls? The easy way is you just find out the section area of the extrusion. You find out density of the aluminum of material. So then you can find a unit per inch weight of your material, then times stock length long. How long your stock length? Normally, aluminum is 24 feet, which is 288 inches long. For the rubber, for example, Carnier rubber of gasket for the glazing is 500 feet long. So let's start to get how I get the weight. First of all, you go to the website, find out the densities of your aluminum. For example, for aluminum density, you just go searching aluminum, especially engineering book or tools. So then you will find out, for example, normally curtain wall made from aluminum 6061. Which is called aluminum alloy 6061. Okay. Aluminum. So if you searching for that, you will find out, for example, this one, aluminum. Okay. It's aluminum. So this is the weight of, let me see which one is much better, this one. Okay, aluminum alloy 6061. The density is 2720. So I just put on the top, aluminum density 2720. Kilograms per cubic meter. So I also converted to the pounds per inches, per cubic inches. So, for example, this part is Carnier 1600 series. Part number is called 162064. If you go to Carnier catalog, you can find out what it looks like of this okay, 162064. This morning, this part number, this morning is 8.25 inches morning, 2.5 by 8.25. So how can I get that section? Okay, you just open that AutoCAD Inventor. If you have this file 162064 created, so you just easily go to under the inspect, then click the area and click the section. You instantly get section areas, which is 4.16 cubic inch, square inch. The part is here, 162064. The section area is 4.16. Not only you can get it that the property of the section areas from Autodesk, and you also can get it from AutoCAD. This what I get that one. So you create the profile, you just modified from Corning website, download CAD drawings, modified, take out all that unnecessary drawings, and then you get the region. So you create a region of this profile. Then you type command mass prop. Click this region, then you will get the property of mass prop. So you get property of this extrusion. So you'll find out they're gonna have areas here. So regions areas 4.16035 is how I get this one, section areas, both from AutoCAD, mass property command, or Autodesk Inventor. So you get section areas, so you times density of aluminum per cube inch. So you get 1 cubic inch weight of the extrusion. If you materials comes with 24 feet, you just times 24 feet times 12, or you see just simply times 288 inches, which is one stock. 24 feet is 288 inches. So 288. Use that unit weight times 288, you get 117.74 pounds per stock for this material. You're doing the rest of all the other materials for the aluminum, you get all the similar results. For example, this can work 162003. The stock length weight is 59.07 162003. What is that? So let me search 162003. This one, 5 1/4 lightweight molding. Okay, this weight per stock. Also, you can get the rubble same way. For example, 162310. This is called isolator or thermal brick for the 1600 Carnier system. So you either can using Autodesk Inventor to find out the properties the same way as I show you before. So you just under inspect, click areas, you'll find out section property, which is 0.169 square inches. 0.169 square inches for this section area. So you can using that gasket densities. So use this section area times the gasket density, so you can get unit, this unit weight per inch length of this rubble. And normally this rubble comes with 400 feet, so you just use this unit weight times 400 feet times inches, which is 1 foot is 12 inches. So you totally get one row with 400 feet long is 35.75 pounds. So this rubber is come with 500 feet. You're doing the same way, you got 39.53 pounds per row. So then you, when you order materials, normally they'll provide per box or per row. It's not get you whatever feet. For example, if you order these materials, 900 feet will come with two row, which is 1,000 feet. So they will not give you 900 feet of rubber give to you because they have to cut off. So because the pay row is 500, so we'll give you two rows. So one row is 39.53 pounds per row. This is how we get all that materials, stock length, weight. So also PVC, because some materials we have PVC thermobreak. For example, 1600 Carnier UT system. Normally they combined with 1600 materials plus PVC added together. So for example, 171201, this part, 171201. This 1600 UT, you're gonna find out this material, they're gonna use this extrusion plus PVC in the front. This extrusion, for example, for this one, 161201, this part, by using 162001 plus PVC. They're gonna use this one combined with PVC, and then you get another part. Do you see that? This 162001 and plus this PVC, they generate another one. So for this part, we're using this part weight, which already have 162001. Okay, here, the weight is here, 50.58 pounds. Plus PVC. The PVC nose, you'll find out PVC nose how much weight they have. It's 3.8 pounds. So you just use that part, that weight plus the PVC weight, and you get another part weight. Also, use the same way I got the door, aluminum door weight without glass. For example, Carnier narrow style doors, 190 series. You just using top rail, bottom rail, and side style, and the glass stop, all added together, you can get narrow style doors normally about 24 pounds per leaf of the door, and medium style doors about 30 pounds per leaf. If it's a white style doors, about 40 pounds. If you add the middle rail, you will add a little weight here, so you're coming to another weight. So this easily you find out, no matter it's a stock length of material outdoors, you can roughly find out the weight of stock length materials or the door lift. I hope you're enjoying today's topic. And if you have any questions, you just leave comments below. Thank you for your watching today.